that not only Bengali culture, but also in Hindu culture or Indian culture, we have always had goddesses who have been very fluid in their sexuality and their gender identity. The fire god Agni was born of two mothers, Dvi Matri, as depicted in the Vedas. Exploring your gender and sexual identity is a very normal thing to do. Schools need to be a safe space where young girls can grow into confident women. It is your duty as the education minister to hire counselors who can comfort girls and let them know that we do not have to live in a heteronormative society. All gender and sexual identities are okay.
Lesbian, gay, bisexual, transgender people have always existed within society, although marginalized and invisibilized, but they have always been there. It's very problematic that he is making statements about homosexuality without being informed. At one level, we have the government which is rolling out its Sathia program, which aims at sensitizing peer educators who will be working with young adolescents about how homosexuality is natural. But at the other level, we are having this minister who is supposed to be the education minister who is making statements which are problematic. You cannot discriminate and cause so much harm and distress to young students just because they display affection or friendship towards other women. So instead of the children, it's really the staff that needs to be sensitized, and I hope that the government can do that.
So first of all, I would like to tell you there is nothing called as Bengal culture. And also by saying that, girls should not promote lesbian activities in school, just shows how homophobic they are and how they think of something that is so natural as breathing, and they just condemn it. I would just request you to kindly let the kids be and not impose your homophobic ideas on them and spoil the generations to come.
In all schools, sex education should be a very important part rather than hushed up conversations in biology or life science classes. One's sexual orientation cannot be categorized or stereotyped, and it shouldn't be done. What these girls have been subject to is something which is very traumatic, because I have faced the same in school. People didn't know how to react to me, to not categorize or kind of generalize somebody on their identity.
It is against Indian culture to be against homosexuality. It is not Indian culture to be discriminatory. It is Indian culture to be accepting. But further than that, I think this argument of culture is even so subjective, in fact, and need not be brought into this at all, because this is a straightforward matter of fundamental human rights, especially that of privacy, which has been granted to every citizen of the country. So there is no question of there being culture being involved in this at all. This is a matter of privacy. This is a matter of human rights. Let's talk about that.